I'm Worsley. I use he/him pronouns. I'm the executive director here at Bruns. We are thrilled to have you folks here with us for the Young People's Symphony Orchestra Summer Pops Concert. Yay! We like to begin here at Cal Shakes by acknowledging that the land upon which we gather is the ancestral home of the Chochenyo Ohlone people. We and our partners at East Bay Mud take our stewardship of this land very seriously. We're going to ask you folks to please join us in those efforts by making sure that all your trash, recyclables, and compostables go into the proper receptacles. I ask you to please be mindful of how much water you use. If you smoke, your mother is very disappointed in you. But if you must, there is one and only one place where you can smoke here in the Bruns, and that's at the far end of the plaza in the Sharon Simpson Center, next to the fire hydrant. Imagine that. Emergency exits are located stage left, stage right, directly up the hill behind you. Restrooms in the cafe are located in the Sharon Simpson Center, stage left. There's a bunch of great things happening at the Bruns. We encourage you to take a look at our calendar and please come and join us for more fabulous activities up here this summer. Our calendar is posted and there are a series of yet to be announced marvelous things happening up here. We hope to see you all here at the Bruns again. It is now my pleasure to introduce you to Nani Liu, the orchestra manager. Orchestra manager!
Well, I don't think I can top that speech. Well, so thank you so much for joining us for YPSO's 86th season. We're closing out the concert with this wonderful Summer Pops concert here at Cal Shakes. And a shout out to all of our hosts here at Cal Shakes, Clive, Cheryl, John, and Jerry, and everybody else who's working the grounds today. Thank you. And thank you all for coming here today. I'm grateful that you're here to support our students, hear them perform, supporting your kids, your grandkids, your nieces, your nephews, your friends. You're what makes this, doing all this, worthwhile. I also want to thank the YPSO board members who are here, who have put in a lot of time and effort volunteering and making this concert a success. Yvonne Brouard. There you are. Rupa, Krishnan, and if there are more board members, please stand up, because there's a lot of faces to see here. Thank you. I also see a lot of new faces here tonight, and I want to welcome you here and share with you a little bit about who we are. YPSO is a youth orchestra. We're based in Berkeley, California. We're serving the whole Bay Area, actually. And we're dedicated to musical and personal individual excellence. Our mission is to encourage young people to become exemplary musicians and young musicians to become exemplary people. YPSO was founded by Jessica Marcelli in 1936 because she needed to create a space for herself as a conductor, a woman conductor, because those two words weren't often seen together back then. And even today, I think there's room for that to grow and to move forward. And when I think about that story, I think I can see that journey in every student here. That their journeys mirror Jessica's journey, and it's one of strength, creativity, resilience, and success. And I mean, look at this institution, we're 86 years and growing. So. I hope that you'll share that experience today as you enjoy this performance. We're gonna hear some great orchestral works, some fun pops tunes, and also celebrate our graduating class of 2023. Students who have really, truly lived through some challenging set of years with the pandemic, the shutdown, the opening, the shutdown, Zoom lessons, and here we are. So we will do a graduates walk at the end of the concert set, so stick around and support them for that as well. I think you're here really to see these guys perform, so I'm gonna stop talking and I'm gonna introduce to you our concert master, Kai Matera.
Thank you, everyone. Thank you all for coming tonight. Thank you to Cal Shakes for... Is that better? Okay. I'm being coached. And thank you to Cal Shakes for hosting us tonight. It's wonderful to be here, even with the challenges of the wind and a few other things. But we'll see how it goes. What we're going to be giving you tonight is a combination of highlights from earlier in our season, plus some numbers which I think you'll find just fun to listen to. The first piece we're going to play for you is Dvorak's Scherzo Capriccioso, which is the very first piece we played on our first concert this season. It's just a... It's a lively dance movement, starting out with a horn solo, and then finally joined in by the full orchestra that plays the opening themes twice with slightly different instrumentation. And then we go into a central section, which is kind of a little bit more moderate waltz. And then it works its way back through that fast opening section again. And just before the tail end, we get a brief cadenza by the harp, and then the end just takes off and rips forward to the end. So here is Dvorak. Oh, before we will play Dvorak's Scherzo Capriccioso in a moment. But first, we need to tune so their instruments don't get cold while I'm talking. So here we go. Thank you.
Thank you.
Edward, Duke Ellington, was one of the jazz greats of the 20th century, particularly in the middle of the time. He was a wonderful pianist, a great band leader, and a fine composer. He wrote many songs that are very memorable for all of us. And today we have a medley of four of them, prepared by a wonderful orchestrator and arranger named Calvin Custer. The four songs you're going to hear are Don't Get Away Much Anymore, Do Nothing Till You Hear From Me, The One and Only Sophisticated Lady, and then It Don't Mean a Thing If It Ain't Got That Swing. So we'll play those for you right now. Thank you. go to another great light classical composer, Leroy Anderson. He was a remarkable man in a lot of ways. He knew 9 languages. He played about 5 instruments, all of them well. In fact, formed a string quartet near the end of his life, which played publicly a great deal. But in the 40s, 50s, and 60s, he wrote hundreds of short pieces. He really defined the 3-minute or 4-minute popular tune. It's always in 3 parts, with the idea of beginning with a kind of gimmick, which could be a pizzicato polka, trumpeter's lullaby, lute tango, any one of those things, and then a middle section, and then the main theme comes back, so that it becomes 3 parts. John Williams at one point commented about the fact that Leroy Anderson was probably the most outstanding composer of light classical music that America has produced. We're doing one that's a little bit different. It's called Ballad of the 2 Left Feet. And it's a lesson in musically how to be klutzy but not klutzy at the same time. Because the idea is the phrases are of sort of uneven length. Some things come offbeat here and there, but I hope we find it great fun, and we hope that you will find it fun too. Here is the Ballad of the 2 Left Feet by Leroy Anderson.
Thank you.
now we return to some of the repertoire that we did on one of our concerts. Our most recent performance, we performed Hindemith's Symphonic Metamorphosis on Plumes of Paper. Hindemith was German, and he had become quite popular in Germany until Hitler came to power. And then in 1940, Hitler forbade his music in Germany. So Hindemith came to the United States to teach and to compose. In his home, he and his wife had a four-hand arrangement of a number of duets by Carl Maria von Weber. And he came up with the idea, first of all, of turning some of those tunes into a ballet, but that didn't work, so he changed it into a symphonic piece, which became one of the most popular pieces he ever worked with. The first tune is called Turandot, and if any of you are opera fans, you know of the, that's the last opera that Puccini wrote. That was based on a novel, and Weber had the same interest, and so this was the closest thing he could come to an Asian tune. He got it actually from Jean-Jacques Rousseau, of all people, and Rousseau made a caveat to it. He said, this may have been tampered with and it may not be a genuine Asian tune. But anyway, so what Hindemith decided to do with this was to create a theme of variations. And one of the side points is that there's a huge number of percussion instruments involved in this. So you will hear the percussion doing their own thing from time to time. But it starts with the statement of the tune by the flute, very simply, and then imitated by other woodwinds, and then little by little, we speed it up as the percussion takes us into a faster tempo. And then the strings play bits and pieces, play the tune. In the middle, he does a jazz variation of it, and there's a big timpani solo in the middle of that. And then, gradually, we come back to the original version of it, and then finally there's a little mini cadenza by the percussion section by themselves, and then finally we bring a little bit to it. So here is the Turandot movement for Hindemith's Symphonic Metamorphosis on Themes of Weber. Symphonic Metamorphosis, which is just simply entitled March. And I think the music will speak for itself. Here it is.
So that we can continue for this generation and future generations of kids to go through a wonderful program where they're going to be great musicians and great future leaders. But while I could speak for it, I think it'd be much easier to hear it from some of our actual musicians. So I'm going to introduce them, or you can introduce yourself.
Hi, can I hear you? Okay. Past year, been in the first violin section for about 4 years now, since freshman year. And I would say in the 4 years of being here, I've learned that people interpret music differently, that music means different things to different people. And we all play differently too. So me specifically, what music means to me in YPSO is those moments when the lines of music all come together and just create like a whole instead of a collection of parts, more like a unanimous, in sync orchestra. And we felt that today too in Hindemith when we were playing it. But overall, I think those moments especially make why it's so important to me, personally. So yeah, I'm gonna pass it on.
Hi there, I'm Noah. I'm also the first violin section. This is my last concert of 4 years as well with YPSO. What music means to me, I'm not sure in general, but orchestra, specifically YPSO, during the pandemic was pretty much my only source of people my age, and I'm very glad that I was in it. I really enjoy playing orchestra pieces because, I don't know, I'm not gonna say that they're better than solo pieces, but they're very different, and I very much love playing pieces with other folks as well. I'm gonna pass it off.
Hi, I'm Ariel. I play soon, so something different. It's kind of always been my dream to play with an orchestra, so that experience of joining YPSO, I think the first rehearsal, the first thing we played in the full orchestra section was Check 5, which was astoundingly beautiful. So just having had the opportunity to continue having those moments of exploring the beauty and joy of classical music and making so many friends, and it's just been wonderful. There's not really a clear set of words that can describe it. You just have to listen to it.
Yeah, thank you. Those words were so, I couldn't have even, the feeling is so great. And, you know, again, I just wanted to help ask for your support to continue this program. You know, whether it's, you know, $20 that can help us provide sheet music for a musician to play, or, gosh, $1,700 for a full tuition scholarship. We would love for you to help support us. There is a donation QR code in the program, or there's a donation jar outside if you want to. Or if you want to volunteer your time to help us with this awesome program, you know, we'd love to have some volunteers as well. Just contact me. Okay, well, enough about this. I know you guys want to have an intermission and break time. The cafe is open. Intermission is 30 minutes. There will be some chamber music on the stage, too, so if you want to grab some food and check out the chamber music during intermission, that would be lovely as well. See you back in 30.
Thank you, everyone. From the turn of the 19th through the 20th century, England was very, very proud of its military. And Elgar was no exception to that. Marches appear in much of his music, but specifically there were five marches that he wrote called Pomp and Circumstance. This is one of them, the fourth one, and it was written in 1907, and it's just fun, so we'll play it for you now.
Thank you.
now we go to a composer that had a very different relationship with the march, John Philip Sousa. I was just recently reading that when he became director of the Marine Military Band in 1880, and then later on formed his own band in 1892, there were very few orchestras in this country. And as a result, a lot of the music that people were hearing at the end of the 19th century and the beginning of the 20th century in this country were bands. And he raised it to a whole new level and also codified the way that a march would be written. They're generally about 4 minutes long and usually have about three parts to them. We're going to be playing two of them for you today. And the first one we're going to be playing is Semper Fidelis, which was the march that he wrote for the Marine Corps Band. And it became their signature too. Now, one of the things we do generally every year is that we create an opportunity for someone to fundraise us by purchasing the opportunity to guest conduct YPSO. And that is going to be done this year with this piece. It turned out that one of the person who will be conducting today is one of our own members. Please welcome her. I just forgot her first name. Her first name is Kasandra Dagnese, and she's done a beautiful job in conducting, so I think you'll enjoy her very much. Please come up, Kasandra. Thank you. going to continue with music with a steady beat, but it's going to be something a little bit different. This is music by Johann Strauss Jr., generally known as the Waltz King, but he also wrote a lot of different things, including a number of novelty tunes. And this one is called Perpetual Motion. He just simply starts the orchestra going and gives you one tune after another, after another, after another, almost a kind of theme and variations, because the harmony remains the same. And it's interesting to see how many different types of things he can put over. So here is Johann Strauss Jr.'s Perpetual Motion. Second program this year, we played a number of selections from Manuel de Falla's ballet, The Three-Cornered Hat. The plot basically revolves around the adventures and misadventures of a very attractive young miller and his beautiful wife. They're very much in love, but they also just have a lot of fun flirting with other people. And so there are a number of things that happen as a result of that. We're going to play two dances for you. The first is the Miller's Dance, in which he's just simply showing off to the crowd. And the second is there is a corregidor, an official, who thinks that the wife has been serious about her flirtation, and he leads him into misadventures, and all sorts of things happen. And so they finally grab him at the end with the general dance and toss him up in the air on a blanket. And it's all in good fun, and everybody is happy at the end. So here are the two dances, Miller's Dance and the final dance from the three-quarter tap by Manuel Divided.
Thank you. Thank you.
You spoke a few moments ago about John Philip Sousa and the band that he developed in 1892, which toured and was very successful in spreading music throughout not only this country, but throughout the world for almost 40 years. In Christmas in 1898, he learned that the manager who had been managing their tours had died of a heart attack in the office. So he was in Italy at the time. He managed to get to Genoa and then to Paris and then headed for New York. And on the way to New York, he started thinking about how much he loved our country and what the flag stood for. And so he began working through, as he put it, his mind band, composing a new march. And so he landed on Christmas Day that year. By that time, the march was finished in his mind. He went straight to his office and he wrote it down without a change. In December of almost 70, 80 years later, President Ronald Reagan declared this our national march. It has been generally recognized not only as a great march, but Sousa's greatest march. So we're going to close our program with it for you today. Stars and Stripes Forever by John Philip Sousa. Thank you. before I turn the microphone over to the students, I would just like to say to each and every one of you in the orchestra, thank you for a wonderful season. I hope you've had as much fun as I have doing it with you. Thank you so much.
Gathering. I'm Yvonne Gerard. I'm the YPSO board president, and I've had the pleasure of being a part of YPSO for 11 years. And every year when we have the graduates have their ceremony, I just am amazed because it's such a pleasure, first of all, to hear them play. And it's also just incredibly astonishing how gifted they are, not just in music, but in everything else. And when you see where they're all going and what they're all doing and what their future careers will be, you realize they're future leaders and they're just wonderful people. And I feel like, you know, youth programs like this and music, of course, but just youth programs where kids can be together and can enjoy each other musically and socially. Are really just amazing, wonderful things. The other thing I wanted to do is say that it's a tribute to YPSO to know that so many of our alumni have returned tonight. They're done with their college for the year, and here they are back to see their friends in the orchestra. Not just the student alumni, but also the parent alumni come back. And so thank you for coming back, and welcome, and again, it's just wonderful to be here. So congratulations, graduates. Please come up. Okay. In a moment, we'll have you come up just a second. Okay, graduates, you're going to be called up and you're going to get your certificate from Nadia and then have a word with Maestro. Grace Brandis. Grace has been with us for only this year, but has been a wonderful addition, and she is going to UCLA to do group performance and goodness knows what else. Linus Buchholz. Yeah! Linus has been with us for three seasons and went on tour with us to Europe, and he is going off to UC Berkeley to study astrophysics and math. Wow. Calvin Chen. Part of the orchestra for 5 years, survived COVID with us, which was amazing, especially for people who were wind and brass players, because they had to play over a thing called Janulus. Calvin is going to UCLA to study biology. Maya Cox. Maya has been with us for three seasons or four seasons and is going to Wellesley College. Lily Crook. Lily has also survived five seasons of YPSO and is studying ethnomusicology at UCLA. And August has been with us for 2 years and is heading off to the University of Chicago to study molecular engineering. Theo Ford. Theo has been with us since 2019 and is going off to Wesleyan University. Hasti Hidayati Parsa. Hasti has also been with us since 2019 and survived COVID. And she's headed to UCLA to study integrative biology and physiology and is pre-med. Sophia Lee.
Yes, Sophia!
Sophia's been with us since 2020, and she's off to Barnard College, that's part of Columbia University, for those who don't know, and she's studying physics.
Yes,
Leah Madigan. Leah's just been with us since 2021, but she's headed to Vassar to study literature. Noah Marvey. Noah's a long-timer, pre-COVID, from 2019, and they are going to McGill University, the Schulich School of Music, to study violin and other types of music, I guess. Kai Matera. One of our co-concert masters this year, and he's been with us since 2019, and he's going to UC Berkeley. Richard O'Donnell. Oddly enough, right after Kai and our other co-concert master, and Richard is going off to Williams College to do violin performance and economics. Thomas Renton. Thomas started in 2021 also. He's off to UC Davis to study marine biology. Ivan Richards. Ivan's going to Cal State Northridge to do viola performance. And he's been in the orchestra since 2021. If my frozen hands can turn the page. Ishan Silveraja. Headed to Santa Clara University. We've just had him for a year, but we've enjoyed having him, and he's going to be studying biotechnology. Ariel Spagnolo. Ariel is a lifer since 2019, and he's going to UC Santa Barbara, where he'll be doing physics and also playing in a woodwind ensemble. Simon Starbuck. Simon's been with us for 2 years. He's off to UC Berkeley to study material science and engineering. Rocco Stilton. Rocco's just had the 1 year on base. He's off to Tilburg in the Netherlands, to the Fontes School of Fine and Performing Arts, presumably to be there. Aaron Sue. Yeah. Erin wins one of just a few awards for the longest. She started in 2018 and is going to Columbia University to study electrical engineering. Colin Sweeney, another long-termer, started in 2018 and is headed to the University of Washington to study engineering. Chester Wanchoba, another one from 2018, and he's off to Northwestern University to do applied math. Emily Yap. She's been elected this year, but she's headed off to Scripps College. And last but not least, Athena Zapantis. And Athena is heading to Johns Hopkins University. She'll be doing civil engineering with a minor in music. We'd also like to congratulate somebody who couldn't be here tonight, and that's Philip Munn, who was with us from 2019 and is off to Davidson College next year. Congratulations, everyone. You're all amazing. Thank you to all the parents who make all this happen for all these kids.